Hello, thank you for choosing Jones Taxes and Financial Services. My name is Shanita Jones, CPA, and I'm the principal owner here at Jones Taxes. This video has been recorded to kind of help you out along the way during this tax preparation season. So this video is for our business owners. Business owners, one of the first things that you'll be given is a link to our business tax organizer. You may also be given a list of things to help you to get ready for tax preparation to make sure you take advantage of every deduction and credit that is legally allowable to you. So whether you receive a link or you go to JonesTaxesOnline.com, you will be using the business tax link. I will not walk you through the entire form, but just know that this form is encrypted with bank security. And all of the information we are asking for is to ensure that we can complete your return accurately and capture everything that should be included in your tax return. Notice, if I try to click next without filling in key pieces of information, the form will not allow you to advance to the next portion. One of the main things that we need from our business owners is going to be a profit and loss statement and a balance sheet. A profit and loss statement shows your income and expenses by category. For instance, your income may come from service revenue, maybe there's tuition, maybe there's commission, different streams of income that you're going to get. You're going to go ahead and list those. This includes Zelle, Cash App, PayPal, Venmo, Cash, QuickBooks Payments, Square, Stripe, or any of those other things that we may use to get payments. All income needs to be included on your profit and loss statement, also known as your income statement. We are also going to need your expenses. Your expenses are going to be anything that is ordinary and necessary for you to operate your business. And if you are a business owner and you don't have an accounting system in place that allows you to have a profit and loss and balance sheet, that is one of the services that our company provides. So you can definitely speak with us about seeing about having us do those things for you. So in addition to these items, we're also going to need a balance sheet. If you are a partnership, an S corporation, or a C corporation, there is something included in your balance sheet called your equity section. That is basically what is your stake in the company? What is the value of it where you are concerned? The IRS requires us to put this information on your business tax return. We can't do that if we don't have that. So we can assist you in getting that together, but this is why we ask for this information. Now, there are a few pieces of information unique to business owners that we want to make sure you guys are giving us. So this is a video. If you are not equipped with a pen and paper right now, you can certainly come back and watch it later, or you can pause it and grab one and we can go from there. If your business is in your home, we need the total square footage of your office, your exclusive dedicated office workspace. And we also need the total square footage of your entire house. This will allow us to calculate your business percentage. We also are going to need all utilities, electric, gas, cable, water, internet, security, you name it, we'll take it. If you have a home office. If you are in the retail arena, and you are using your space for storage, it doesn't have to be exclusive. Beyond that, it should be exclusive space for business if an IRS agent were to come up and do an inspection. Also, we'll need, if you rent your home, we need to know how much the rent is. If you own your home, we'll need to know the purchase date of your home, the purchase value, and the value of your land. This will allow us to calculate the depreciation expense for your business use of home, or it will allow us to determine how much of the rent is deductible. We're also going to need to make sure you capture your mileage. If you use your vehicle for business, MileIQ is a great app. If you're using QuickBooks, it comes with some of the versions of QuickBooks as well. If you're ever audited for mileage in your business, the IRS is going to ask for a written log of how you went, where you went. So we request all of this information to enable us to get you the best possible tax outcome. If you're saying, well, Shanita, I don't have a profit and loss, or my business is a Schedule C, we have you covered too. This is a PDF version. This isn't the prettiest form, but this form does have all of the information that I discussed. And on page 4 is a very simple format where we ask for your business name, your structure. Are you a S Corp, C Corp, sole proprietor, nonprofit? It asks for your income. And then we're asking for some of the categories that may apply. This is not all inclusive. It is not intended to be, because we really want our people to actually have accounting records for their businesses, and we can help them get set up with those if they don't. So I am going to leave this video here. If you have any questions, the best way to reach us is via email at our team at Jones Taxes Online email. We do have a 2-day business response time, and we usually hold to that during tax season. So if you're trying to reach us, we appreciate you. We will get back to you. We just want to make sure we're giving everyone the attention that they individually need. Thank you so much for your time and your business. And the best compliment you can give us is a referral. We appreciate you. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.